Greetings, friends. Today we are having a discussion on the mission legal awareness. And today's video will be on solicitorship in the United Kingdom. Introduction. Advocate Abdul Muheeb will be our speaker, and he is an aspiring young and dynamic practicing advocate. He is an engineer turned lawyer and a passionate mentor and teacher. He teaches governance, constitution and polity in the Hyderabad study circle for UPSC civil services aspirants, and also he teaches to CLAT and other law entrance examinations. You can contact him on 7989-310-387. Introduction to today's topic of solicitorship in United Kingdom is under our knowledge series. This is for Indian advocates and legal knowledge series. I hand over the mic to Mr. Abdul Muheeb. Thanks, sir, for giving us time today.
Thank you very much. So today we will discuss about a solicitorship in UK. So before moving further, I greet everyone on the occasion of Children's Day. So good afternoon, good morning or good evening. So to all the viewers who are watching this channel and learning something new today. So today our topic, as our dearest friend has already introduced, is solicitorship in UK. So before moving further, I would like to discuss about who is a barrister and who is a solicitor. Now, there are many differences between a solicitor and a barrister. Now, when we talk about the barrister, now in history we have ample examples, but I would like to mention some five names whose introduction is not even required. They are famous all over the world and they are considered to be the best minds of India. Some of the examples which comes to my mind or to our mind, and I would also request the viewers to mention some of the names who has done their barristership in UK. So I would like to take some names. The very first, the Mahatma Gandhi, who completed his barristership in UK, went to the South Africa and led a movement there and came to India, and he became the Mahatma Gandhi. The second name which comes to my mind is the Jawaharlal Nehru. He was the first Prime Minister of India, and today on his birthday, we are celebrating the Children's Day. The third name which comes to my mind is the B.R. Ambedkar, who is considered as the father of Indian Constitution. The Ambedkar was not only the constitutional expert, he was a master economist and a statesman. The fourth name and fifth name which we have seen in our times is the Somnath Chatterjee, who was the Speaker of Lok Sabha and the former CJI of India, Chief Justice of India, Muhammad Hidayatullah. So after discussing a barrister, so who is a barrister? Now we can understand the barrister by a simple definition, that is, barrister is a lawyer who has been called to the bar and is qualified to plead cases in high courts. Now, a barrister can be called upon to prosecute a civil litigation and to defend in another. So he plays a multiple roles, sometimes as a defender and sometimes as a prosecutor. But today's lecture is based on solicitor. In the coming sessions or in the coming videos, we'll discuss about who is a barrister, who is an advocate, who is an attorney. Today we will focus on who is a solicitor. Now, a solicitor is also an attorney who advises clients, draws up legal documents, represents clients in lower courts. As we have discussed, the barrister appears in high courts, whereas solicitor represents clients in lower courts, prepares and assists the barristers. And if we establish a relationship between a client and a barrister, and a client and a solicitorship, the relationship is based on contractual agreement. So these are some of the finer points we have to know about who is a solicitor. Now today, this video is being made to know about how to become a solicitor in United Kingdom. It is sometimes United Kingdom is also known as England. And in when we see our European countries, UK is considered to be the house of the law. Their law, their legalship is the best around the world. Now, how to become a solicitor? How to become a solicitor? There are various exams. Previously, it used to be just a legal exam. Now, from this year, from September 2021 onwards, the UK government has started a new program called SQE 2021. Now, all the previous exams will be phased out by the year 2032, and the SQE will be streamlined altogether. So, what are the advantages of this SQE exam? Now, as we are in India, and most broadly, all the South Asian countries who want the members from the South Asian countries, whether they have a legal background or not, they wonder whether we can do legal field or whether we can practice legal law in England or not. So the best news for us is, like, all the South Asian members, whether they belong to legal background or not, they can do this exam, they can take up this exam and practice law in England. It is very simple and it is very flexible. So what are the advantages? Why we should do the SQE exam? Before going more details about the SQE exam, let us know what are the advantages, what are the facilities we will be having after completing the SQE exam. So let us discuss the advantages. So the very first advantages is an individual decision. No one can compel anyone to do anything. As a person who wants to pursue law as his career, he can do his as an individual decision. Second thing is, like, there are many more opportunities in various countries, and many of the countries, based on the British standards, appoint lawyers. Even if we go to the America or any other countries, this qualification will be helpful. They might give some exceptions to it, but more or less the law is similar in all the countries. Now, the third is, like, the coaching programs is available across the globe. Even if you belong to Pakistan, even if you belong to India, even if you belong to Bangladesh, even if you belong to Sri Lanka, all the South Asian countries, this coaching is available. Third is, like, they can attempt 3 times. This, when you apply for the SQE exam, you can attempt it 3 times and you can complete it within 6 year phase. Fourth point is, it is more flexible. Now, previously, what we have to do, we had to go to England for pursuing law in England. But with the SQE, they have brought a program saying that even if you belong to any other country, you can give up the exam in your home jurisdictions. Now, today in India, because of the COVID and other problems, some of the centers have been closed, but now they are all opening. Now, to know exact the centers and everything, you can log on to the official website of the SQE and book your slots. The fourth is, like, as per the law wishes. The syllabus of this SQE is designed such a way that it is very flexible, it is divided into parts, and even the fees is very moderate when compared to other countries. So let us discuss some of the questions or the queries many of the students will have. Let us go it one by one. For the facilitation of our viewership and all the viewers across the globe, I have made a series of FAQs where the viewer can go exactly at that point and know what he wants to know. So let us talk about some of the FAQs. Now, the very first question which comes to our mind, what is SQE? The SQE is Solicitorship Qualification Exam. Now, who conducts this exam? There is a regulation authority who conducts this exam in the UK, and the exam is online. What is the eligibility criteria of this for taking up this exam? Broadly speaking, even if you are a non-law background, even if you doesn't know anything about legal, you can take coaching and can become a legal expert. The fourth question is, like, can it be taken by foreign students? Yes. As we are Indians, we can prepare for the exam, but as a foreign student in UK, once you clear this exam, you can go and practice the law in England. Now, what is the process? What is the timeline? What are the different parts? This is the question. The timeline of this SQE is of 6 years. Once you enroll for the SQE, you have to take SQE 1 and SQE 2. The SQE 1 and SQE 2 exams are done at an interval of 5 to 6 months. For example, this year the SQE exam 1 was conducted in November 8th and the next SQE exam will be conducted in after April. For schedule, you can refer to the official website. The third thing is like, if you fail in the SQE 1, you can retake the exam without going through the whole process again. And you can give this exam 3 times at a phase of 6 years. Then if you cannot clear this around 6 years, you have to start the whole process again. So the next question is, what is the fee? Presently, as per the official website of this SQE, it is £1,558. I would like the viewers to please check the exchange rate online so that there will, you know, the exactly how much you have to pay. The next thing is like, is the coaching available in India? Yes, the coaching is available on the various platforms. They can be available offline and online. If any viewer want to take coaching, can contact us by the given numbers and the addresses. Yes, the next question comes, can be exam taken in home jurisdiction? Yes, the exam can be taken in home jurisdiction. All the centers are given on the official website. And for at present, it is available in different states. It is available even in the South Indian states also, specifically from where I come. The third is like, some of the solicitors or barristers from India. Yes, there are many. And you can check up online. Can you find any of the solicitor who has done his solicitorship from UK? Third, the next question is, what is the syllabus for the exam? What is the pattern? Let us discuss the syllabus of the exam. The syllabus of the exam can be explained by SQE 1 and SQE 2. As we have already discussed, SQE 1 is of part 1 and SQE 2 is of part 2. Now let us discuss what we have to study in SQE 1. The SQE 1 exam, it consists of two parts. The first part is known as the Knowledge Test 01 and the Knowledge Test 02. In the Knowledge Test 01, there are 7 subjects which we have to learn. The first subject is Business Law and Practice. Second subject is Dispute Resolution. Third is Contract Law. Fourth is Torts. Fifth is the Legal System of England and Wales. Sixth is the public law and the seventh is the legal services. So these are the 7 subjects you have to know to clear the Knowledge Test 1. Knowledge Test 2, it starts with the property law and practice, wills, second one, wills and administration of estates, third one, solicitors accounts, fourth one is the land laws, fifth is the trust and equity, sixth is the criminal law and practice. The Knowledge Test 2 is more based on the practical application of theory concepts. Whereas Knowledge Test 1, it is more of theory. Now, after you complete your SQE 1, about an interval of 4 to 5 months, you will be allowed to take up the SQE 2 when you clear the SQE 1 exam. So, let us discuss the SQE 02, the second part. So, SQE 02 Part 2 exam is also called as Legal Skills Assessment Exam. What is the eligibility to take SQE 2? As you already know, you have to clear the SQE 1, both the parts, part Knowledge Test 1 and Knowledge Test 2. So what are the subjects which are covered in the SQE 2? There are 6 subjects, whereas the SQE 1 consisted many more subjects. So SQE 2, subject 1. First one is the client interviewing techniques. Second is the advocacy techniques. Third is the legal research. Fourth is the case analysis. Fifth is the legal writing. And sixth is the legal drafting. Now, after all this we have discussed, the very next question which comes to our mind, when will be the exam conducted? This year, as per the official website of the SQE, it was conducted in April and in the October. If you give your exam in October, the next SQE 2 will be conducted in April and the cycle goes on. Now, if you are in England, you can give up the exam in London, and if you are a foreign student, you can check up the foreign jurisdictions where you can give the exam and become a solicitor. Now, the practice context, the major import they, the SQ exam gave importance to the criminal practice and other civil law practice. So, after this, what is the mode of the exam? Whether this exam will be conducted offline or online? As we are in the digital age, the 21st century, most of the exams are conducted in online base. And even this SQE exam is conducted online based. Now, what will be the structure of the exam? The structure of the exam, we will have the for SQE 1, part 1, the knowledge test, there will be 180 questions. And for each question, there will be 5 options. You have to select one option. Similarly, the knowledge test 2 will also have 5 options, 180 questions, and you have to clear it in a time-based manner. The second SQE 2 is based on the practical applications and it is very different from the SQE 1, but the legal knowledge is very important. Now, many of you might be wondering whether we have any contact number, whether we can contact anyone. Yes, you can contact. There is a website called as Pearson VUE website. In India, the Indian website will be india.pearsonuae.com. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot for giving your time. It was of great knowledge.
Thank you very
much. I summarize it in short. What you are trying to say is, for an Indian advocate to practice law in United Kingdom, he need not compulsorily do LLM or LLB in United Kingdom. You are saying that they can write QLTS exams, SQE 1 and 2, and the first part is multiple choice, and then you have a written and the oral thing in United Kingdom. And after that, you can practice as an advocate in the United Kingdom. This is what you are trying to say, sir?
Yes, sir, exactly.
Thank you.
So, in the last thing, if any of the viewers or the legal aspirants who are watching this video can contact us for more information, and if they want to pursue the coaching for this, we are very pleased to announce our program, which you can contact us and know the other details. Thank you very much.